the middle for Ott. He scores! Steve Ott on the one-timer scores in his first game as a Buffalo Sabre.
Steve, tell me a little bit about playing in Buffalo and what it means to you to be a part of the Buffalo Sabres and that city.
Well, first off, the Buffalo community, the fans, are extremely passionate. It's a great place to be a Sabre. They have a lot of pride there, and they want to see the team have success. They've welcomed myself, my family, from day one with open arms, very first class, from ownership down, and it's great to be a Sabre.
Tell me about your style of play. You're known as one of the agitators. Is that a learned way to play the game? Is that just the way that you want to play the game?
It is. I'm a very competitive person, and if you usually challenge guys and to compete every single night, if it's their best player or their bottom guy, most guys don't want to ring that bell, and that's something that I pride myself on, is trying to show up every single night and be competitive, be consistent with it, and also having the hands and the ability to score and produce numbers as well. So, trying to bring an overall game most nights is something that I've tried to do over my NHL career.
You're the type of player that most players say they hate to play against and they love to have on their team. Would you agree with that assessment?
I hope so, absolutely. When it's game time, there's no better time for myself to bring out that kind of emotion that I play with, the tenacity or whatnot. But then away from the rink, I just want to be one of the boys, a good teammate, family man, and kind of go from there. And that's something that guys have to learn is to park it once the rink is, I guess you can say, away, and have that home life as well.
Have you ever been surprised with a player who's been able to go toe-to-toe with you from the insult department?
I haven't found him yet, so I guess that's why I'm still around in this league. I'll keep doing it. And I had a chance to play with Matthew Barnaby, and we had a lot of fun and a lot of laughs together, I guess you can say, even though we bumped heads when he was with the Rangers, and had a few great fights. But no matter how many years you've finished playing with a guy, you always have that same bond, and it was like you were with him yesterday.
He made a great play. Oh, it was a great play.
He's probably the closest guy I thought that we had some good lines together.
Ryan Miller, your goaltender, endured a lot of criticism last season, and there's always trade rumors around him. How do you think he has handled that as one of the leaders on the team?
I think he's handled it very professional. He's a very passionate guy. He's a guy that sticks up for his organization, his teammates, and not only is he a great goaltender, he's a great leader on our team. Without a letter, without a CRA, he's still one of our top leaders on our team, and he demands respect, and he gets a lot of respect in that dressing room from all of us.
Tell me what the expectations are this season for the Buffalo Sabres.
Expectations are definitely to be a playoff team. We have a young hockey club, guys that need to take that next step and find their identity. And there's a lot of guys that definitely want to improve off last season. It was atrocious in the accountability department, in the sense we didn't make the playoffs. And we want to be that playoff team. We know what it takes, and doesn't matter how many points you miss out, you still missed. And for us to take that next step, we have to follow a strong process with these young players. And look, after Christmas, I think we really start finding our identity.
When you look at the realignment of the league, will it make things more difficult from a postseason perspective, getting that spot in the Eastern Conference?
It creates a pretty solid battle. Not only are we adding another strong team in Detroit, and plus Tampa and Florida, what a division it's going to be. I think it's probably going to be the best division in the NHL. Seeing the rivalries that are already, have made themselves or form-fitted themselves in the last few years, and adding those strong teams in, it's going to be an extremely competitive division.